Hi friends, welcome to the WebLogic session. In this session we are going to look into how we can upgrade our WebLogic Java, which we are using, the underlying JDK which we are using. If we have to upgrade the JDK, then what are the process which we have to follow? So in our case right now we are using JDK 1.79 that is the one which is being used for my WebLogic. So let me, for my WebLogic 11G, let me just show you Oracle 11G. Here if I have to show you, I can open one of the file, cd utils bsu and cat bsu.sh. So if I open this, you can see here, this is the Java home which is being used. So the Java version which is used by my WebLogic is 1.79. So now if there is a need in which you have to upgrade your JDK to a newer version which is available in market, so what are the steps which you will follow in order to upgrade this JDK? So one way is to download the latest version of JDK and install it inside the same folder, in this same folder which is there, and you don't have to make any changes. Other way around is you install the JDK at some other location, and then we have to make the changes in these files which are referring to the our Java home. So let me show you inside your WebLogic which all files are there which are referring to this JDK. So let me search here. So I will use the find command and name, and I'm just searching for all the sh file, all the scripts which are making use of this this JDK. So let me go to the WebLogic home. So I am here at this location and I will paste my command, and it will show me which all places this JDK is being used. So it is used inside WebLogic home, common bin, common environment.sh. It is used in BSU, it is used in quickstart.sh, it is also used in uninstall.sh, as well as it is used in setdomain.sh. So in all these files we have to make the changes to point to the new JDK. So the another thing is, before making any changes, we will have to go to the Oracle website and download the latest version of the JDK, or on the JDK which we want to upgrade. So here 1.780 is available and we are making use of 79, so we'll upgrade it to 1.780. so that is what we'll do. So first thing is, you have to download this JDK based on your operating system, if it is 32 bit or a 64 bit. So you will do that. Let me download this, and once it is downloaded, we will make use of this JDK and upgrade our JDK for WebLogic. So now I have downloaded the latest version, that is JDK 1.780 on my machine. So let me just go and extract it and put it on some another location. So I can use rp, it is tar-xvf and jdk7u. So we'll do this, and it will create a folder for me. So 1.780 has been created. So let me cut this and put it inside the Oracle folder. So let me go inside Oracle, and here let me put this JDK so that it is uniform. You can put it at any location, whatever location is you are comfortable. So I put this JDK here. So now my JDK location becomes, let me show you, so cd JDK 1.780. so this is the location, new location. Okay, no, I don't want to next up Oracle. So this, we can also navigate through slash Oracle JG 1.7. So this is the part I will use the for my 1.8 version of JDK, that is Oracle and / JDK. So now I have to find out which all files are making use of this the old JDK. So I have run the command here and I was able to find it. So these are the files, and these are the files which are making use of the old version of JDK. Let me copy it, put it in a document so that I have all the files. So let me go to this set domain environment first, and let me go here, let me do a cat paste. So let me do a vi, cat will not help, vi, and then I am here. So before making any changes, it is always recommended to take the backup, so cd. So otherwise, if there is some problem, then in that case it will be you will face a lot of issue to get it back up. So it is always recommended to take the backup of the files which you are going to make any changes. So before making any change, please take the backup. Once the backup is done, now go to the location where, so Java home is set. So this is the location. Let me just do an I and paste the new location, which is Oracle JDK 1.780. I will paste it here. So make sure that there is no space and it is correctly pasted. So, and the location is, and here also we have one more location where we are using this. So we have to make sure that all the places where this JDK was referred, we will make the changes. So I've saved it here also, and then there is no other places where it is being used. So I made the changes in set domain. Let me make the changes in other files as well. And let me go to this. So let me go to this file, commonenv.sh. So again, you should make a backup. Let me again go and take the backup, because if we don't have the backup, it will be very hard for us to recover back, and it will be again a problem for us. So it's always a good practice to take the backup of the files which we are going to change. So now, let's see where it is. So here is the path which is mentioned here. Let's remove this path and give the new path here. So let me copy it again, paste the file here, the location where my this is. Let me check again, there should be no other location where it is being, it should be referred. So it's not there. And then the next file which was there is bsu.sh. let's go and make the changes in this file also. First we'll take the backup. Then we'll make the change in the bsu.sh file. We'll point it to the new. So let's do it for two with it. We are not gonna use these. You can do it at later point of time for these files as well, because BSU when you are patching, then only you will use. So yes, when you are doing, do it for all at the same time so that you don't miss it. And quickstand and all we have never used, but as we don't want the reference of the previous file here, so we will make sure we make the changes in all. And the last file which was here, uninstall.sh, let me go and make the changes. Let me do it. In your case, please take the backup of all the files, otherwise you may end up in a trouble. So backup is always recommended. So now I have made the changes in all the files. Let me run the command again and see if we are able to find anything. This time it should show me nothing. So no files where it is referring to this one. Let's make the changes in this. Let's show the the new JDK 780. Let's find, yeah, so these are the files in which we have made the changes. We are able to see it here, and these are the sh files. There are other files also in which this JDK is referenced, that we can make the changes, or if you want to leave it, you can leave that also. Let me show you, there are so many files. Yeah, so still in our domain there will be. So these are the logs files. We are not worried about the log files, let it be there. And this is also log. So these XML files are there. If you want to make the changes, yes, you should do. And yeah, this is one more important file, node manager dot property. Here you should make the changes whenever you are doing. And few files again, let me copy all of them. Let's see which one is important and which one we can leave. But yeah, you can do it in all the files so that you don't face any issues. So here, yes, domain token, this one, this is a log file. I can remove this. This is the backup file which we have done, and this is again the backup file which we have done. This is the log file, I don't require. This is the BSU util old, I don't require. And this is the util. Yeah, so these files are again still left out where you have to make the changes. So it's good that we make the changes so that nothing comes up in little point of time. Take the backup of all the files where you are making the changes. And here you can see, and domain Java home is still here. Make the changes to the new location, whatever is there based on your system. Same way we have so make the changes in all the files so that it does not everything is in sync, and you don't face issues at later point of time that somebody say that this version of Java I can see in this log file, or others are having different values. So it is good that you make the changes in almost all the files. And it's not more than 10 or 10 files in 11G version of WebLogic. So it will not take much of your time to do these changes. So let me search where is my... Yeah, so here is the JDK location. Let me just change it to the newer one. is in token properties also. Copy this again. Here is the Java. Location I have done, and one more is here. This is the product property file. You can make the changes in this also. See how many files are there. So NodeManager.log, we don't want to make any changes in the log file, that is a log file. Yeah, so this NodeManager property file is important file, so we'll make the changes in NodeManager.property file to point to the newer version of JDK, and let our all our in servers in sync. If NodeManager is another JDK and your WebLogix managed servers are in another JDK, they may create a problem. So each of the components of your environment should be in the same version. So I might just change here, and the last file, which is the product dot, that is related to coherence. Let me just make it change so that we do not find anything in our output when we are running this command. So now I've made the changes in all the files. Let me again check if there is any reference of user older version of GDK in any of the file. So these are the log file. I can ignore. Okay, so this file still have GDK 1.79 reference there. So let me just copy and see where is that. We'll make the changes accordingly so that the output, we should not get anything JDK. And I think, yeah, sorry, there were two places where this JDK was being referred. Let me just make the changes in all the places. Paste it. Yeah, now let's run it again. If it is log files, we are not, we are okay. And so all these are log files, okay, for us. Set domain old. Okay, so this file still has another point where, so make sure you make the changes at all the places and do this check each time before migrating it. Okay, so because if you do it if you don't check it correctly, then in that case it will be a problem. So yes, here is the path we have missed this. So make sure you check 5 to 6 times before you start your servers and make the changes, reflect the changes, so that you don't miss anything and everything goes fine. So now we can see all are, these are the old files, the backup file which I took right now, and log file, log. Yeah, so I think in all the files which we are having, user java jdk 1.79 has been changed. So now Let me just run the set domain command, and then we will see which Java it is using. And the bin folder, and now let me run the set domain command. This will set the path, Java path and all, and java-version. So you can see it is 1.780, the newer version of Java which we have. Let me just start with the servers and see /start weblogic.sh, and here you can see the latest version of Java is now being used. So this is how you can make the changes in the weblogic, and you can upgrade the JDK version from one version to another version. Make sure that all the files where these things are referred, you make the changes in all the files. Hope you are able to understand, and you will make these changes in your environment. Be very careful whenever while making these changes, and have a copy of backup with you. Thank you.